9 record shooting, 46.5 overall, and 36% from the three. Well, Ed, the Pistons second from the field in terms of field goal percentage, and the Stars third in terms of three-point percentage. So really some big D is necessary by both sides.
Oh, it's going to be really big for that tonight. As we've been mentioning time after time, defense is what's going to win championships. And tonight, I think that's exactly what we're going to see. We're not going to see a slow start by any teams. They're going to come on right out from the beginning and get on top of each other.
Well, like the Saints, the Waikato Pistons have had a long layoff, 8 days. So how has this affected Murray McMahon's side?
I think it's good. We're freshening up and we're ready.
What's the feeling like in the camp?
It was good last night. We had a walkthrough, looked at some video, went through a couple of things that we want to do on defense, and then just shot around, and I think we're ready.
When you were scouting the Stars Heat game, what did you pick up on the Stars to tackle them offensively?
They are very active. I'm sure that they'll extend their defense out on us and try and make us work all the way down the court. They'll try and take the ball out of Jason Crow's hands. So we're just working little things to help that, and we'll see how it goes.
Yes, Coach Murray McMahon looking to extend the D and take the ball out of Jason Crow's hands. Now, Ed, say someone's just joined us in the semi-finals today. Could you elaborate a little bit on that? Like, how are the Stars likely to do that?
Well, what the Stars are going to do, they're going to try to extend a little bit further out than what they normally do. Normally, they take a step back in those easy passes. They're going to really put the pressure on, especially when they put the passes. They're going to try to get into the passing lane and make it really tough for the Auckland Stars and the Waikato Pistons to pass the ball.
Well, the Auckland Stars came out firing in the first quarter in their playoff game against the Heat, so are they looking to do the same again tonight against the Pistons?
Yeah, we need to come out focused. We did a great job of that against the Heat. That first quarter played very well. We need to do that with the same focus and the same mental toughness that we showed 2 days ago.
You faced each other last Thursday in the Thursday night throwdown. It was level pegging until Casey Frank got fouled out. Tonight, obviously, you don't want to get anyone in foul trouble.
No, that's the key for us. We need to keep Casey and Dylan on the floor for most of the game. We can't have them get in foul trouble like they did against Pistons last time, and the Heat even on Wednesday. So we need to do a good job defensively so they don't.
What's the feeling like in the camp?
Oh, we're positive. We're ready. You know, we're looking forward to this game. We played well on Wednesday. We want to build on that. We've got a lot of motivation.
Yes, the two captains, Casey Frank, Pero Cameron, having a chat with the referees. And Ed, what are they likely to be listening to right now? What is Gavin likely to be telling them?
Well, it looks like Casey Frank was ready for a fight there. But I think what they're just trying to do is just to explain the rules, how they might be trying to call the game tonight, and just trying to keep it clean and let it be a good play tonight.
Well, Kenny Stone mentioned about keeping out of foul trouble. How important is it to have Casey on the floor? Actually, in fact, Ed, if Casey wasn't on the floor, like that game in round 15, how could Kenny Stone counter the Pistons?
It's very important for the Auckland Stars to keep Casey Frank on the foul floor. If you see him getting into one or two fouls, I think they might drop into a zone to try to protect him. But if he does get into foul trouble, you need the guys like Reese Cassidy and guys like that to step up and to play a big part, especially Valance McCarthy.
Well, looking to play a big part is the starting five for the Waikato Pistons.
Kerry Cameron, power forward from Whangarei.
Brian Weathers, shooting guard, California, USA.
My name's Mike Hummick. I'm a forward, and I'm from Hamilton, New Zealand.
Kia ora, Pookie Linden. I play guard for the Waikato Pistons. I'm originally from Hawke's Bay.
Jason Crow, point guard from Inglewood, California, USA.
I still love that wink. Yes, on the bench are Ben Hill, Ray Cameron, Prem Krishna, Mika Silva. Now, Ed, the question on my mind is, can the Waikato Pistons rely on Crow and Weathers, or do Crow and Weathers have to share the load, in particular if they're trying to take the ball out of Crow's hands?
It's going to be great for Waikato to get Jason Crow and Brian Weathers going. Once they get going, they got to start to share that around, and the other players are going to need to step up. We need Pearl Cameron to step up. We need Benny Hill. You got Mike Hommick. You got a lot of those guys who need to step up, and especially in crucial games. This is semi-playoff basketball, and it's going to be hardcore, and people are going to be ready to play.
Well, speaking of players looking to step up, let's meet the starting five for the Stars.
Dylan Perfect Tee, guard from Rotorua.
Hi, I'm Dylan Boucher. I'm a small forward, and I'm from South Auckland. Hi, I'm Casey Frank. I'm a forward, and I'm from Auckland.
Hi, I'm Adrian Mastrovic. I play forward for the Auckland Stars, and I'm from Perth, Western Australia.
My name is George Baker. I play point guard for the Auckland Stars, and I'm from Kentucky.
On the bench for the Stars, Reece Cassidy, Jonathan Shepherd, Tyrone Davey, Joss Clark, just to name a few, I should say. And I'm looking forward, Ed, to the battle between the Kentucky boy, George Baker, and Jason Crow. They were going at it hammer and tongs in Auckland. And George Baker's got to be careful. He can't get into foul trouble like in round 15.
Oh, it's a great matchup. We got two top guards going at each other. And as you mentioned, Dennis, he needs to stay out of foul trouble because he is a key to run this offense and to run this Auckland Stars team. And if he can stay out of foul trouble and put the pressure on Jason Crow, it's going to be a great game. And it's going to be a good battle to see.
Ed, how's the size difference going to impact the Stars?
As we saw last game, basically Waikato was too big and it really put the pressure on the Auckland Stars' big guys and got them into foul trouble, and that's going to be the tail of the game. They need to stay out of foul trouble to have a chance of winning this game tonight.
Well, who will join the Wellington Saints in the finals series next week? Will the Stars add the Pistons to the teams they've eliminated from the competition, or will the Pistons prove too strong on home turf and beat the Stars as they did last week? It's time to join our Commander-in-Chief, Lieutenant Dan Hennessy and Ed Book, as we get set for tip-off and semi-final two between the Pistons and the Stars.
Well, thank you, Dennis. If I'm the Commander-in-Chief, I will make you my mercenary of mojo. You're my man. And for the rest of y'all, welcome along to Super Duper Semi number 2, coming to you live from the Te Awamutu Event Center here. Lieutenant Dan Hennessy alongside the Big Easy Ed Book. And sometimes a team with nothing to lose is a team to look out for. And these Auckland Stars here were basically on basketball vacation, on holiday last week. They got thrown back into the mix. They beat the Heat. They find themselves one game away from the finals. Big Easy, is that a Cinderella story or what?
That's what championship dreams are made of right now.
Yes.
Basically, out of the competition, back into it, and now they want to prove why they should be in this competition.
And, well, again, another massive basketball crowd here in the Waikato. Crow, Weathers, Tandemonium, we've been talking about them, we've been touting them all season long. It's almost like they have to win. They've got everything to lose, and the Auckland Stars are refreshed and rejuvenated, and they're ready to rock. This is going to be a tight one right down to the wire. Our officiating crew is Melanie Whelans, Gavin Few, and Tim Swift Justice Brown. Here we go. Hammock and Casey Frank to tip it off. Pookie Linden will get the rock off to Jason Crow, and the Pistons will have first go here on offense.
Waikato showing some patience here on this offense, running it out. And as we can see, Terrell Cameron taking it straight at Casey Frank, trying to get some fouls on him early.
Beautiful pivot move from PC off the glass. Fantastic footwork for the big man.
It's going to be a tough ask for Casey Frank to try to defend Terrell Cameron into this post. And I think this is what Waikato needs to keep on doing.
Mastrovic, short shot, yes, gets the shooter's roll. And that's two for him. And also, it's going to be tough for Casey to stay out of foul trouble while he's doing that with Peyro.
Not an easy task, but he's going to have to try to do it. If he does get a couple fouls on him early, expect Auckland Stars to go into a zone.
Crow finds PC again. PC needs help. He finds it with a cutting Pookie Linden, and he will be fouled by Dylan Perfect-Tate here.
Auckland Stars are trying to double team Terrell Cameron, try to give Casey Frank a little bit of help. And this is one thing Terrell can do in the post is make these passes. He's one of the better big men in the league to make passes like that.
Good dish from PC, definitely. Pookie Linden at the line now. Here's his first. And that one will rattle out. And the second one is money for Pookie. As the Stars now come down, here comes the country boy, George Baker. Dylan Perfect-Tate rolls around the outside of the outskirts. And we've got a foul off the ball here.
I think we have an offensive foul on Auckland Stars.
And that'll be on Dylan Boucher, his first, and a quick one on Dills.
And Dylan's another one that has to worry about his fouls. Last game against North Harbor Heat, we saw him spend quite a bit of time on the bench.
Yep.
And as we see, Kenny Stone pulling him off early, only playing 1 minute, 11 seconds so far.
But in saying that, the guy that just replaced him, Reese Cassidy, played phenomenally against the Heat.
He had a great game against the Harvard Heat, and hopefully he can have another one.
Jason Crow with it, top of the key. Finds PC again. PC working down Casey Frank, doubled now with AJ and Casey, looking to dish it off somewhere, and he will get called with a travel there. Gavin Few is right on top of that situation.
We saw Waikato the last three possession down. Perro Cameron touched the ball each and every time in that post. And I think they're going to try to run the offense around him because he is a good passer from there. And if nobody comes for that double team, expect him to take it straight at Casey Frank.
All right, George Baker, Country Boy, launches one. Bang! Country Boy leaves the hand in the air. He knew that was going in the second it left his hand.
He's continuing his fine form against North Harbor Heat, where he left off with some great shooting percentages from three. And as you can see, that was the first strike.
PC with it now on the outside. Casey Frank still on him. He's going to put one up. No, he's not. Give it to Mike Homick on the outside. Six left of the shot clock here. Nice scooping shot from Homick. No good. Frank with the rebound. Here come the Stars now in transition. Casey Frank brings it up all the way himself. Looks for help. Finds the Country Boy from the other side. And that is off the mark. Weathers with the rebound. Now here comes the counterattack. Oh, beautiful dribbling skills from Weathers. Coast to coast. Dishes it off to Homick. Outside to Pookie Linden for three. Whack! And that was a beautiful basketball play.
Beautiful basketball, and as we see, already starting really well, shooting the ball well from outside both teams.
Country Boy down low, gets two more. Oh, Belcher with a steal, of course, back to the Country Boy. And he will not be fouled somehow. Weathers ends up with it, dishes it off to Crow. Crow penetrates, finds Pookie Linden, puts up a 20-footer, and that's off the back of the iron. Country Boy on the run.
George Baker calling out some offense, trying to get him into it.
Dylan Boucher with it now, finds Casey Frank. 11 on the shot clock here for the Stars. Mastrovich now working on PC. And PC will be called with his first foul of the competition. As Adrian Mastrovich just sort of bounced off him there. And AJ's not a small guy by any means either.
He's not. I think he's going to feel a few more of those before the game's over tonight.
And another quick whistle there. That'll be on Jason Crow. That'll be his first, which is rare for Jason Crow. Sometimes we've seen him throughout the season get his first foul in like the second, third quarter sometimes.
Jason Crow has quick feet and he does really well on defense. He moves and he slides and he tries to get in front of the player.
Dylan Boucher with it now. Set piece coming up for the Stars. Casey Frank for a three. Whack! Casey Frank can shoot from outside. And we have Jason Crow bringing it up now. 6-10, Auckland's up four here. 6:22 left to go in the first quarter. Jason Crow for three. And that will rim out. Dylan Boucher scoops up the rebound, does a little tightrope dance there, stays in bounds and finds Casey Frank all alone for the big set down, Casey!
And that's how you finish the play down low. Casey Frank running the floor really well for a big guy, and he's finishing on the other side over Perro Cameron.
And the Stars again are playing exceptionally here early, as they did against the Heat. Mike Homick working on AJ now. Homick stops, spins, puts up a shot, no good. Mastrovich with the rebound, good defense from AJ. He'll kick it off to the Country Boy, and they are just in control of the ball. Boucher with it, finds Dylan Perfect Tate, over to the Country Boy, George Baker. AJ in the corner, baseline he goes, stops and pops, rims out somehow, and Dylan Boucher knocks it out of bounds.
We're gonna see what happens this time down on offense. Waikato, first three or four plays going inside to Perro Cameron, worked really well for them. The last couple plays down have gone away from him. Other guys to get in touch like Mike Homick. But I think they need to go back inside to Perro Cameron.
All right, Jason Crow walks it up here. Finds PC. A rolling Brian Weathers. Weathers needs help, and he will be partially blocked by Casey Frank, but Casey will be called with a foul here. Thought he had some ball.
It's only the first foul here on Casey Frank, as we saw him go up with a fake.
Good camera angle, good work by the production crew there. Might have had a little bit of arm as well.
Yeah, I think it's a little bit of arm as he came down. He probably got the ball first, but touched the arm after that.
Weathers nails his first here. Brian Weathers and Jason Crow still have not been picked up yet in the Australian Basketball League. And I'm sure there's a few scouts out there watching this game tonight, wondering if they should add them to their roster. George Baker with it now for the Stars. Dylan Perfect Tate open for three. You don't want to do that. Somehow he misses. Casey Frank gets an offensive rebound and a beautiful back scoop shot to get two more points.
Yep, Casey Frank with the first offensive rebound of the game and puts it back in over Farrell Cameron.
Benny Hill with it now. Working down on AJ. He'll spin, little fadeaway, and that's just money for Benny Hill.
He is a tough player to play inside the post. He gets really good position. And he backs the guy down, and he has that really nice fadeaway jump shot.
So hard to defend. Casey Frank into Dills. Dills goes baseline. Nice, beautiful stuff from Dylan Boucher.
Yeah, good spin around. Waikato's playing a little bit of a switch in defense right there. Dylan seeing that and spinning around on Pookie Linden for two.
And Benny Hill and Adrian Mastrovich are just jamming at it off the ball. Benny's got it now. 11 seconds left in the shot clock. And he will draw a foul on AJ. Benny Hill going to the line. And once again, as always, whenever we come to the Te Awamutu Event Center, who's the first one out shooting here out of anyone? Benny Hill.
Yep, he's out there. He's always working on a shot. But Benny knows how to use his size. He really gets down low, as we can see here, as he backs into Adrian Mastrovich, and he takes it up into him.
Benny Hill misses the first. Ray Cameron into the game now for the Pistons. And he has had some fantastic minutes for the Pistons all season. Very much a breakthrough year for Ray Ray.
He gives him that spark off the bench. He comes out and just brings a lot of energy. Hustling all the time. He does all the dirty work that nobody likes to do. As we see, as George Baker went through the lane, Benny Hill giving him a bit of a shot.
Casey Frank with it. Casey goes back. What kind of a shot was that? Somehow it missed. It almost went in, though. Beautiful stuff from him. Here comes Weathers now. In transition, stops and pops the tray. Bang! Brian Weathers, automatic! 2-point spread. And we've got another foul off the ball here. I believe it might be on Jason Crow, and that's his second foul.
That's his second. This is not a good thing for Waikato Pistons right
now.
Wow. Basically, Auckland using that pick and roll, as we mentioned before. Waikato switching on defense. Auckland Stars taking advantage of that mismatch between Casey and Jason Crow.
Casey Frank with a long two, no go. Who's got it? Ray Cameron comes down with it. Here comes the counterattack now by the Pistons. Look at him go. Oh, he misses it somehow. Rolls off the rim. Jonathan Shepherd with it. Finds the country boy. Nice pass into Boucher. Look at that. Ray Cameron up in the air. And that will be a foul going to the line. Beautiful stutter step by Dylan Boucher. Caught Ray Ray way up in the air.
I think that was great recognition by Dylan, as he got Ray Cameron up in the air. He went up and put the shot up, but the referee said it was on the ground and the ball's at the baseline.
Not a high percentage shot by any means, was it? Jonathan Shepherd with it, loses the handle of it. Casey Frank tracks it down and back out to George Baker. Didn't see the pass coming from Casey. So it will be Pistons ball here.
I think if Jonathan Shepherd could come out like he played against North Harbor,
yeah,
really came out of his shell, started to shoot the ball really well, he's going to be a big help for Auckland Stars.
Yeah, Jonathan Shepherd and Reese Cassidy were very big reasons why they won that game against the Heat. Look at Ray Cameron just running people over. I wonder where he got that from. And we've got a jump ball.
Ray Cameron not giving up on the play as he shot, missed it, went back straight up, got his own rebound. But they got tied up with the jump ball, and it's Auckland Stars ball.
Well, check this out. Whack. Down goes Dills. And it's a bit of a scrum happening there after that jump ball. There's Kenny Stone just still barking out instructions. calm and poised in, at the moment. Shepherd with it. Got B-Dub on him. AJ, shot off the rim. No good. Bounce of the ball goes the way of the Stars. Dylan Boucher with it now. Fresh shot clock for the Stars. Finds Jonathan Shepherd in the corner. Shepherd stops, gets it back out to Casey. Casey thought about the three, goes in a little bit, stops and pops and nails it again. And the Stars are just shooting the ball really, really well.
Auckland shooting the ball really well, shooting at 57%, 8 of 14, and also 2 of 4 from three-point line.
Mike Comic with it now for the Pistons. Finds Prem Krishna. Over to Brian Weathers. Weathers dribble penetration stops at the charity stripe and puts it down. And Brian Weathers wants to go on in this league, I can tell.
Brian Weathers having a good first quarter, sitting on 7 points right now, being very aggressive and trying to attack the Auckland Stars defense.
Dylan Boucher with it. Nice behind the back pass to AJ. Tries to go baseline. He will be fouled by Mike Homick. And in, I don't know. Let's have a look at that. Playoff basketball, I mean, is that really a foul?
As you mentioned, Dan, this is playoff basketball, semifinal playoff basketball. You want the players to control the outcome of the game. You know, let them play a little bit, let the game flow.
I think at halftime, we should go down there and take those little balls out of their whistles.
There's already been 9 fouls called in this game. It's only the first quarter. That's quite a lot of fouls being called right now.
Masterovic at the line shooting his second, being hassled by these crazy bells down here. And we've got Pookie Linden coming in for Ray Cameron. Good minutes from Ray Ray, once again, getting amongst it. 1:29 left to go here in the first. Waikato Pistons 16, Auckland 19. Weathers in all kinds of trouble, somehow gets the rock back, finds Prem Krishna, back to Weathers for a three. Oh man, Brian Weathers is just playing unconscious as the cowbells continue to ring.
He's come out to play, already sitting on 10 points.
And that'll be a walk on the country boy, left without his luggage, traveling. We're all knotted up. Pistons chance to go ahead here. First time in the competition.
There goes Peril trying to seal Casey Frank down low.
PC with it now. 9 on the shot clock. Down to 8.
And here comes the double team.
Nice pass to Homick. Casey Frank will end up with it though, but Pookie Lindy gets a hand up there. And now Homick's got it. And they'll get 2. And it's great hustle from Pookie Lindy and Mike Homick.
That's it. They didn't give up, even though Auckland Stars had the ball. Waikato stayed with it and came up with 2 out of that.
Casey Frank down low. Yes! Right over Pookie Lindon. Here comes Prem Krishna now. Finds Brian Weathers. Reese Cassidy right on him. 8 seconds left. Not much between the shot clock and the game clock. B-Dub puts up another tray, and that's off the mark. Country Boy with it, and he's going to put it up now and does so. And he will miss the long shot, but that's the end of one here, ladies and gentlemen. And the Stars aren't going anywhere right now. We're all tied up, 21 apiece. Gentlemen, this season, for the first time ever, it's all about the rings. To purchase your first ever ring, go to gameface.co.nz and or trademe.co.nz. They are funky, they are cool, and again, for the first time ever in 27 years, it's good enough for the Yanks, it's good enough for the Australians, it's good enough for Kiwiland. Am I right?
You are right, Dan. I wish it would have been good enough for us last year. Now, I'm not going to let you forget this one.
I know. Let's listen to Coach Kenny Stone.
Because Piro's not rolling. They're both, the bigs are just staying.
Are they fading or just standing?
Fading or standing.
Okay. All right. Let's switch it. All right, let's switch that. But you got to make sure we're up on that. Don't switch from over there. Okay? Get up on that so we know. All right? If he starts to roll, then let's show and recover. Okay? But right now, let's switch it. Offensively out of this. Let's go green 4. Green 4. Okay? Look. when you come off that screen, right to there. Okay, don't go any further. We screen, if they go under, you step there. Okay, nail that. All right, our screener, Casey, seal him, okay? All right, down the other end. We gotta do a better job on the board still. All right, no second shots. All right, we do that, we'll be fine. Let's go. Defense, 1, 2, 3, defense.
Well, here's some action there from the first quarter. And it's all on here at the Tiahumutu Center, ladies and gentlemen. We're all knotted up at 21 apiece. Casey Frank with a nice dunk there down low. Beautiful stuff and applauding himself there. And there's a scrum that broke out. We've seen a few of them in the playoffs, and they'll continue to happen because not one rebound is going to go uncontested here in the playoffs. Guaranteed.
As we mentioned before at the start of the game, we knew these teams were not going to come out flat. They're going to be coming out ready to play, and they were as they were battling all the way through that first quarter.
And the one statistic that's sort of jumping out at me on the page here is the Auckland Stars have turned over the ball 4 times as opposed to the Pistons 1 turnover.
Auckland Stars are prone to turning the ball over, but they do need to respect the basketball a little bit more, take that little extra time with the passes, and not try to rush those.
All right, here we go. Second quarter is upon us. Jason Crow with the ball finds B-Dub, who is open for three, decides to penetrate, stops and pops, and oh man, has Brian Weathers got his side alignment on tonight or what?
He's coming out, he's feeling it, and every time he touches the ball, he's looking to go with it.
Tyrone Davey, the young stud here for the Auckland Stars, finds Reese Cassidy, who stops and puts up about a 15-footer, and that's going to go off the top of the structure, not out of bounds, so here come the Pistons. Jason Crow with it, Tyrone Davey on him, and that's fantastic for a young guy like Tyrone Davey to have to try and cover Jason Crow. PC for three. Oh, it rims out somehow, reminiscent of Paul Winnie Thomas shot, and here comes Tyrone Davey, up to Reese Cassidy, up to Casey Frank. He spots up a three. He nails it again! Oh, Casey Frank is playing fantastic hoops.
And Casey Frank is one of our candidates for MVP of the league, and this is why he's showing what he can do right here, and this is why he's actually quite a good selection for the New Zealand Tall Blacks, because he can shoot the ball from the outside and it fits into Nenad Vucinic's offense.
Betty Hill for three from the baseline. No go, and AJ will scrap that down. Here comes Tyrone Davey now. 3-on-4, so he's gonna slow things up. Plenty of time for them in the shot clock with 17 seconds. Cassidy in the corner now. Rolls around the outskirts. Finds Tyrone Davey. He will penetrate. Jonathan Shepard's first shot, no go. There's Benny Hill with the rebound. Jason Crow, ball on a string. Here he comes, 3-on-2, behind the back pass to PC. PC with a layup. Oh man, that's fast.
That was good passing by Jason Crow. And this is why he's so tough to mark, because you had Brian Withers running on one side, Perro coming on the other side, which I don't think anybody saw, but Jason did see him and threw the ball behind his back to Perro Cameron coming in for the layup.
10 on the shot clock for the Stars. Mastrovich has it in the corner, hassled by Benny Hill. He'll stop and put up a shot. Off the rim it goes. Jason Crow scoops it up and brings it over half court in a hurry. He'll stop and put up a three himself. Two bounces, not good enough. He might have needed three there. Didn't go in for him. Here comes Tyrone Davey back the other way. Jason Crow is still scoreless at this point.
We're not going to see that basically much longer. He is going to get going.
Reese Cassidy with it. They're really using up their shot clock here. Are the Stars getting good looks? AJ had one right there, missed it. Why? Because he ran into Perro Cameron and Benny Hill. Pookie Linden down low, up to B-Dub. He's open for a three, and somehow he misses, but there's Pookie with the cleanup. Two off the glass.
Waikato just took a slight lead right now, 25-24, and Kenny Stone wants to talk about this.
Well, yes, you mentioned the Tall Blacks. Let's not forget, the Boomers are coming to town. The 26th from the North Shore Event Center. We're going to be there, Big Easy, and we want you to be there as well. So if you live on the North Shore of Auckland or anywhere in that area, come on down to the game. If not, check it out on Sky Sports. Let's go down to Coach Murray McMahon.
Everybody get back, pack our keys. Are we not? We've just got to get back, okay? Everybody get back. Okay, swing curl with the flare screen. Looking for those flares off that screen, okay? Get in into our postman stall, looking for that, spotting up. Getting good shots out of that spotter, okay? Good shots out of that spotter. Just got to knock it down, but it's still there. Just don't hesitate. Look for it.
Jump ball, side. We don't want them cutting to the ball. Easy catch. It's either 2 points or it's a foul, right? Too many easy stuff.
The Waikato Pistons, heavy favorites here. There's a silver fern, Jolene Henry in the crowd here tonight, checking out the hoop game. Good to see Keith Quinn last night, commentating legend. They're all coming out to see the hoops, and why wouldn't you? Look at that crowd up there, massive. There's not a seat to be had in this place. And here we go, Tyrone Davey will bring it up for the Auckland Stars, who are really playing well here. Got their backs up against the wall and fight out of that corner every time. Casey Frank for three off balance. Oh, Casey!
Casey Frank having a very good shooting first half, sitting on 17 points right now.
Wow.
I don't think he's missed a three yet.
Unbelievable stuff. Benny Hill thinking about the spin around shot. Oh, and it will go in one as AJ collects an elbow to the melon.
Oh, he's going to feel that one tomorrow. I think AJ did a really good job. I thought Benny Hill dropped his shoulder, as we can see, as AJ's taking the bumps here and takes it right there.
Whack! Oh, man! That is going to leave a mark. Benny Hill at the line. He's bad enough to get called with a foul, but then he gets smashed in the chops as well. That's just a double dose of bad luck right there. It is Friday the 13th, by the way. So.
Add insult to injury.
Casey Frank is trying to do it again. And that will not go for him that time. But look at Dylan Boucher scrap for that offensive rebound down low.
That was in between two Waikato players, Jason Crow and Prem Krishner.
Oh, we got a little talking happening down there now.
And as we can see on the sideline here, uh-oh, Brian Withers getting his back rubbed again, probably putting a little heat on it just to try to keep it loose, because he is very loose right now on 12 points right now, not missing too many.
Look at Boucher just amongst it down there, being hassled left and right. And what do we have here? A technical called on Jason Crow! You better watch it. He's going to get kicked out of this game, and you don't want that. Good thinking, Benny Hill. Get him out of there.
Yep. Big game like this, there's going to be a lot of emotions, but Jason Crow has to watch out, because with that technical foul coming up right there, put him on three fouls, and now where is he going? He's going off to the bench, sitting there where Waikato didn't need him.
Wow, Casey Frank misses the first free throw here. As those cowbells keep a ringing. But Jason Crow just letting the referees know how he feels, getting a technical foul here, and that is going to sting the Pistons, because now he's on the bench, Boucher to inbound for the Stars. Tyrone Davey with it. Fresh 24 for them. Inside to Casey. Casey's shot might have been deflected by Pookie Lendon. PC ends up with a rebound. Here comes Prem Krishna back to PC. Nice bounce pass into Benny Hill, working on AJ again. AJ's going to be thinking, do I have one coming to my chops?
Yeah, that was a good double team by Casey Frank. Just not giving Benny Hill a chance.
PC for three. Bang! The trifecta for payroll!
It's very hard to double team off the person who just passed the ball in, because that's exactly what happens. You pass in the post, that person goes off and double teams. They kick it straight back to the guy for an easy shot.
12 on the shot clock. Dylan Boucher with it. Needs some help. Finds AJ in the corner for a three. That rims out. Pookie Lendon scoops up the rebound. Smartly kicks it off to Prem Krishna. Up to PC now. Here come the Pistons.
Straight back into the post. Benny Hill's done a great job picking up where Pearl Cameron left off.
Look at that shot from Benny Hill. Off balance. Doesn't go in for him, though. AJ with the rebound. That is a tough ask for Adrian Mastrovich all night long to be guarding Big Benny Hill.
And this is one of the keys that we talked about at the start of the game, the size of the Waikato Piston compared to what Auckland Stars have.
Reese Cassidy gets called with a foul. Well, check that, he draws a foul. Two shots coming up for him as the country boy George Baker's back in the game for the Stars.
I think what White Kettle was trying to say right there is that as Rhys Cassidy went up, he put out his arm and he pushed off Prem Krishner. So they were looking for an offensive foul instead of the foul on Prem Krishner, which gave him his second foul.
Rhys Cassidy now at the line. Here comes the second now for Rhys. That is good as well. And now the Auckland Stars are just 2 points behind. Very much staying in touch here with the Pistons. Prem Krishner brings it up slowly. Over to Pookie Lendon. Inside to Mike Homick, and beautiful, he was unmarked. Nice pass.
Auckland Stars extended their defense out a little bit, trying to deny Mike Homick the ball. He did exactly what you're supposed to. If you're denied up top, go back door for an easy layup.
Oh, Mastrovich looking to draw the foul, but he'll get the 2 points anyway. And look at the Stars hustle back on defense. They're all back there ready to go. More times than not, you'll see that happen. But with the Pistons, sometimes they lack a little bit in defense, and that's where their flaws lie. B-Dub spinning. Over to Homick for three. No, Krishna for three. He's going to put one up. Beautiful teardrop. No good. George Baker slaps it back to Dylan, and he'll get it back. Country Boy looking to penetrate, finds Dylan Perfect Tate in the corner.
That was ball, good closeout from Brian Withers on Dylan Perfect Tate, because they know he can shoot the ball.
Casey Frank into Mastrovich. Six on the shot clock. Baker puts it up. Oh, and rims out somehow. Who's got it? Offensive rebound, Adrian Mastrovich.
That was good hands by both Dylan Perfect Tate and Dylan Boucher, both getting a hand on, keeping that line for AJ to pick it up.
Oh, Mastrovich nails one from outside.
As we saw in the last couple playoff games, you know, second chance points really hurt a lot of those teams in the playoffs. And this is what Auckland Stars doing really well right now, sitting on four offensive rebounds.
And what has happened to the Auckland Stars the last couple of games? Their shooting percentages have just gone through the roof. They're playing for keeps, the Auckland Stars. Let's rock down to one of the trenches and see what's hip-hop happening. Kenny Stone, what's going down?
Dylan, you're there. I want to go black again, okay? Hold that screen just a little longer, okay? Force that defender to do something before you slip
it. It's not hard. I'm playing flare screen for you.
No, you're flare screen for AJ on the other side. You're coming out of the corner. Okay. This time, let's look at coming out of the corner. So you're there. Casey's coming, okay? You're coming off that, up there. Okay? Here, Dylan, AJ, stay there. Okay.
Again,
hold that, and then once you hit him, then roll.
Make sure
hold it
side.
A second.
Stay on my side.
Okay.
Yep.
Hey,
box out, boys.
Come off his shoulder. Defensively, keep boxing out. Be strong on defense. All right, man up. Let's go. Defense, 1, 2, 3, defense.
Well, it's been a bit of a long-distance shooting barrage here by the Stars. The Country Boy, George Baker, getting into the mix. Casey Frank hitting multiple threes. There's another one. And wow, he's just got his game has just improved. He's got an outside game, he's got an inside game. Casey Frank really playing well tonight here for the Stars and staying out of foul trouble, because that is the Achilles heel of the Stars.
That is the important factor that you just mentioned there, Dan. Casey Frank still on the floor, only on one foul.
Homick with a little fadeaway spin around, no good. Frank with the rebound, kicks it up to DB, one to beat. Off to Mastrovich. Baker now. Prem Krishna working him down. Back to Dylan Perfect Tate. He'll launch a three from the wing. No, sir. Prem Krishna, good rebound. He was hassled by, of course, Dylan Boucher. PC gets it up to Brian Withers. Withers collapsed. Look at that. Casey Frank and George Baker on him. Prem Krishna with it now. Withers the other way. He's like, well, if you're going to block me one way, double team me, I'll rock around to the other ring. Got a good look at it, but it didn't drop in the ring.
Yeah, Brian Withers has gone a little cold. Haven't scored in a little while, but we're not going to expect that to stay long. Auckland really working hard using this side pick.
And Withers is called with a foul here on George Baker. Baker will be going to the line. That's Brian's first foul now.
As we mentioned before, Auckland Stars working really hard on this side ball screen because Waikato's switching, and what they need to do is be a little bit more patient, bring it back, because as Prem Krishna switches onto Casey Frank, they just need to be patient, get him into the post, get it down there, because Prem Krishna can't match up with Casey Frank in the post.
And while the Auckland Stars also doing a heck of a job keeping this massive crowd out of the game, now up by 1 point here. And the first one will drop for George Baker.
Follow shots are crucial, especially going into those last couple quarters. And both teams are shooting the ball pretty okay from the foul charity stripe right now.
George Baker nails the second one here. We're in the shadows of halftime. 2:36 left to go. Auckland Stars up by three. Ray Cameron with it now. Finds Benny Hill, PC, B-Dub. B-Dub working on Dylan Perfecte. That's a mismatch, and we have a foul called on the play as Dylan Boucher has hit the deck multiple occasions so far this first half.
And we're going to see him hit the floor many more times before this game is over tonight.
Three things you can count on in life: death, taxes, and Dylan Boucher going as hard as he can during every basketball game. Ryan Weathers at the line. They're just clearing up some moisture off of the floor here. A little bit of a delay.
Let's see if Brian Weathers can put some more points on the board. He's been quiet the last couple minutes.
First one will roll in. Shooters roll for him there.
He gave a little grunt to get in.
And the second one goes as well. George Baker will bring it up now for the Stars. Casey Frank, Dylan Perfecte. Good passing here by the Stars. Frank looking for Boucher, finds him, but Dills couldn't handle the jandle on the pass, and it will be another turnover here. Turnovers now starting to plague the Stars a bit, even though they find themselves up by a point.
Auckland Stars really moving on offense, trying to get the defense to shift. Casey Frank moving through, untouched. Just missed him, but Dylan Boucher, same thing, in case he tried to get in.
Ray Cameron will draw a foul on Dylan Perfect Tate. That is his third personal foul for Dylan Perfect Tate. The deep threat the Stars got from the Hawks. So here comes in another deep threat. Jonathan Shepard will replace him. As Adrian Mastrovich talks things over here with Tim Swift, Justice Brown. I'm sure he's not asking for directions. Ray Cameron at the line.
There we go. As we heard, he's just asking what the rule is. Yep. It's definitely fair enough.
Maybe he was asking where he could find ESPN and Tiamutu to watch the Celtics game, because we couldn't find a place today, could we?
What a great game that was today.
Sure was.
Boston Celtics coming back from a 24-point deficit. Largest lead in the NBA Finals to come back from.
You're getting on my good side, Big Easy. I like that. Boucher with it now. Finds Shepard open for a three. That's off the back of the iron, and we've got bodies flying down low. Casey Frank hits the deck pretty hard there. Foul on, I believe, Payro Cameron. That is his second.
And the foul count still going up. Waikato sitting on 10 fouls, and Auckland Stars sitting on 7.
And while the shooting has dropped a little bit here for each team, Waikato from outside, 33%, Auckland 38%. PC takes a little bit of a break. That's a lot of minutes from PC. Casey Frank at the line. And that will rim out. Second one is money for Casey, so they're up by one here. 1:37 left to go till halftime.
Here we go. We got Auckland Stars playing a 2-2-1 three-quarter court trap. Just trying to put the pressure on, especially with Jason Crow out, and going to put the pressure on Ray Cameron and Prem Krishna to bring the ball up.
Brian Weathers and one! And wow, does he have a quick step? Looks like his back's fine now. JC Frank's second foul. Right there.
Yep, as we said, KC Frank has been out of foul trouble, but two fouls in the first half, not such an issue. But KC, if you're going to get beat like he just did there, he needs to let it go, and the help side needs to come from his teammates. Nobody really came over from the help side to help him out.
George Baker with it now for the Stars. Was open momentarily for the three. He's going to go in the zone, and he's going to nail one. A nice one-handed shot there by George Baker. Prem Krishna comes back up the other way. Just a minute left to go here in the first half. Mike Homick with a shot. Yes, off the glass. Nice work from Mike Homick.
And they're going back and forth, taking it at each other. No one giving any steps.
They're going at it, hammer and tongs as the country boy launches one, and that's just a little bit short. And, well, the Pistons will maintain possession here. Substitutions or timeout. A timeout called on the court here. Pistons 42, Stars 40.
I think Valens McCarthy's coming in for KC Frank just to give him a break so he doesn't get a foul in these last couple of minutes of the first half.
Good call. Let's sit him down for the last minute of the first half and he can go into the locker room refreshed and come back for the second half. Okay. Let's rock on down to Coach Kenny Stone, see what he has to say.
Wire up Black, okay? You're in the corner, strong side. Let me see that clipboard right there. You're setting it, okay? You're coming on. Val, you're coming up. Shep, you're there, okay? George, you're coming up. Instead of rolling, yeah, I want you to roll there, okay? So you're basically gonna screen and screen there. Over here, Dylan and AJ, okay?
That's Nike.
Okay, George, you hear that? Okay, so if you come off, over there. Okay, so
that's what you're screening. Yeah, I'm split screening, that's Nike. So have a look first. Have a look at that as you're coming off.
Yeah.
Then if it's not there, then look back over this way.
Okay.
Okay, so you know what you're doing, Val? You got the on ball. Okay, let's go. Hey.
Come on, fellas.
We need one stop. Hey, let's stop. Need a stop here and get a rebound. Okay, let's go. Defense. 1, 2, 3.
Defense.
Well, Coach Kenny Stone knows that his Stars are very much in this one. And geez Louise, they're just one game away from the finals here. The Pistons have been heavy favorites all season long until the Wellington Saints found their mojo. And man, did they find it last night against the Giants there.
They found the mojo last night. And I think they'll be sitting at home watching on TV, seeing which opponent they're going to be facing in the finals.
Ray Ray Cameron, poetry in motion, screaming right on down the lane and getting a layup.
It's only about
and look
one
at this,
and
Adrian
a half
Mastrovich
seconds.
Is tying his shoe while they have ball. Not while he ties it, he'll put it up, and that's going to be short. Benny Hill with it. 9 seconds left in the first half. B-Dub is going to be going for the last shot. I guarantee it. No, he won't. Benny Hill launches it. Off the mark it is. Who's got it? Weathers puts it up. It will not count. It will not count. And B-Dub can't believe it. I thought he was going to tackle Tim Swift just as for a second.
Oh, but he couldn't believe it. He thought he got it off in time, but it was just a fraction. As we saw, Brian Withers has changed over to George Baker because Jason Crowe's sitting on three fouls, and I think George Baker is winning that battle between the two point guards.
Pookie Landon all alone. Scooping shot, no good. He will be fouled, however, and KC Frank will collect the foul.
This is not what Auckland wanted to start this third quarter. KC Frank sitting on three fouls. Over the last couple weeks, we've seen KC Frank into foul trouble. And when that happens, bad things happen for the Stars.
Now, when do you think would be a good time to take KC out and put Valens McCarthy in?
I think Kenny's going to let him roll just a little bit longer because it's still early. Because Jason Crowe's still on the court, three fouls. So it's not a huge issue, but KC's got to play smart. So if he does get beat, allow them to go, and you got to have trust in your teammates to be there, and they have to be there for KC with the help side.
Second one is short. KC gets the rebound. George Baker will bring it up, and Brian Withers is on him, and look at this matchup.
Yep, George Baker had a good first half on 9 points, really took it at Jason Crowe, got him into foul trouble, and he's going to try to do the same with Brian Withers.
Seven on the shot clock here for the Stars. Dylan Boucher with it, spins, working on Pookie Lendon. Shot no good, gets his own rebound, however, finds KC Frank, who loses the ball and hits the deck, and then it's stolen back by Boucher. Mastrovich is hacked by Pookie Lendon, but there's Dylan Boucher again.
Dylan's all over the place. as we see, once again, bodies flying all over the place. Oakland Stars not giving up. As we see right there, Casey Frank says, I got hit on the fouls. Got knocked over by PC, but gets straight back up. And Dylan with the pass, as we can see there, to Adrian Matsovich and the foul by Pookie Linden.
Dylan Boucher again this season finds himself an epic defender in this league.
It's really good for New Zealand basketball to see Dylan Boucher back here for the New Zealand Breakers. He's been missed over the last couple of years, but now he can come back and hopefully end his basketball career with the New Zealand Breakers and with the Auckland Stars.
And let's not forget, in the Australian Basketball League, just a couple of seasons ago, all the coaches got together and they voted Dylan Boucher the most underrated player in the whole Australian Basketball League.
Because he's not known for his scoring ability, but he is known for his hustle, his hard work. Those are the things that really don't show up on the stats. Just like right there, getting a hand on the ball there, coming away with it, and pushing the ball up the court.
Casey Frank with a hook shot, too. And Brian Weathers is still looking over Melanie Whelan's, wondering why he didn't get called with a foul. He should really forget about that and just get on with the game.
Yep, Casey Frank picking up where he left off in the first half, sitting on 21 points.
All right, Payroll Cameron for three. Whack! PC for three!
And it's good to see Payroll actually hit a three-point shot. He hasn't made many over the last couple weeks, but it's good for him to get one off right now.
George Baker with it. 13 on the shot clock for the Stars. Dylan Perfect Tate open for a three. A long one at that. Oh, baby! Dylan Perfect Tate hit that one from downtown Hamilton.
Dylan hitting that three, cutting the lead back to 148-47 to the Waikato Pistons.
Jason Crow with it now, directing traffic. He's got the country boy on him. Dribble penetration from him. Back out to Weathers. Weathers penetrates. Back out to PC. They want to get PC out. Look at the passing. That's got to be a three-second violation. But the passing from the Waikato Pistons there was phenomenal.
Few players passed up a few shots there. And Brian Weathers got caught standing too much into the lane with the 3 seconds.
Country boy will bring it up here for the Stars.
Yep, Jason Crow hasn't hit his shot, so he kind of hesitated on that last open shot.
Country boy finds Dylan Perfect Tate open for another three. Yes! Dylan Perfect Tate, back-to-back threes!
And we know he can shoot, so they need to get out there. Be aware, he didn't hit anything in the first half, but we know he can get it going.
Auckland now up by two. 6:45 left to go here in the third. Weathers with the ball for the Pistons. He'll put up a three. And that is off. Ray Cameron scrapping for it. It must have went off one of the Stars now. Pistons will get the rock back.
And what do we see, Dan, once again? Who's hustling out there?
Ray Cameron.
He's working hard as he does every time he comes into this game.
And there's Benny Hill dumping it back off to Jason Crow. Spins it around. PC thought about the three. And now he's double-teamed by Casey Frank and Dylan Boucher. Gets it out to Crow. Crow launches one. And he's still off the mark with his shot. Still pointless is Jason Crow. A calamity. Baker with it now for the Stars.
And we see Austin going back to that side pick and roll.
And stolen by Ray Cameron.
Bit of a tough angle to try to get that ball into Casey Frank. What they need to do is draw another Auckland Stars up to the top, give them to the top of the three-point line to look at a better angle to get the ball into Casey Frank.
And Brian Weathers just can't get over it. Thinking he's fouled every time he gets the ball. Matsovich puts up a three. Oh, AJ rattles it in.
Auckland Stars starting to pull away, sitting 53-48. But this is what we wanted. First half, we said, hey, we think the referee's taking control a little too much. Right now, they're allowing the players to play, so they need to get over it and start playing basketball.
Absolutely. Ray Cameron down low, and he will get the foul in. One for Ray.
He's working hard. He's relentless. Always going, going, going.
And there's Dylan Perfect Tate, just a deep threat every time he gets the ball. And I mean real deep, good people.
As we can see, Ray Cameron backing into Dylan Perfect Tate. Ray knew he was on three fouls, so wanted to take it aggressively at him to get his fourth foul. And he did a great job doing that.
Four fouls now on Dylan Perfect Tate. Not good news here for the Stars, because he is a deep threat every time he gets the ball.
And he was just starting to find his groove, hitting two threes. We can't hit him as he's sitting on the bench.
Boucher with it. AJ thought about the three. Stops and pops about a 15-footer. And AJ has got that 15-footer down.
Adrian Metchevitz starting to feel it. As you can see, he's sitting on 15 points. If him and Casey Frank can continue with it, it's going to be a long night for White Kettle. And we got Prem Krishner coming in for Brian Withers. We might just watch him on the sideline to see how that back's doing, if he's going to get a little bit more treatment.
We've already got our guru down there on the sidelines, Dennis. If anything happens down there, he'll see it. Jason Crow with it. PC.
Trying to take it at Casey Frank, sitting on three fouls.
Ray Cameron out. Nice pass to Crow here. Not much time left here on the shot clock. 4 seconds. Crow's going to put it up. And that's a heck of a way to get on the shot chart.
And once Jason Crow starts to get going, it's going to be hard to stop him.
Boucher with it. Finds Jonathan Shepard for three. Oh, man! And the Stars are just shooting the lights out of the Tiamutu Event Center.
Now, if Jonathan Shepard can find his groove, start hitting from the outside like we saw him start to do against North Harbor, if he can continue to find that, it's going to be a big help to Auckland Stars with Dylan Perfect Tate sitting with four fouls on the bench.
And well, that'll be a kickball, I believe. Will they put on a fresh 24? They're saying no, only 10 seconds left here on the shot clock.
We haven't seen too many smiles on Jonathan Shepard's face throughout the year when he started to play for Auckland Stars. Hitting that shot, put a one on his face.
Mike Homick with the hassle by the country boy, who will get called with a foul here. The country boy, you gotta love it. What's going through that melon right now, huh? White Cattle 54, Auckland 58, 4:10 left to go here in the third. Jason Crow, penetration, out to Prem Krishna. He'll launch a three. Prem off the front of the rim, Mike Comic with an offensive rebound. Crow wants to slow things down a bit.
Yep, Jason Crow pulling it back out. Gonna look to try to take George Baker off there, but trying to get it back into Benny Hill. He did a great job of getting good position and taking the ball at the Auckland Stars.
Mike Homick down low. And one for Mike Homick.
And Dylan quickly put his hand up to try to get the foul, hopefully not on Casey Frank.
Well, the scoring is just unbelievable here. Now they're up to 43% from three-point line. Are the Stars, and everybody's getting into the mix, really. George Baker finds Jonathan Shepard. Over to Mastrovich. Dylan Boucher. Over to Shepard for three. That's gonna be short. Ray Cameron with the bound. Here comes Jason Crow the other way. Looks to penetrate. Might have got away with a walk. Prem Krishna gets two. Nice pass.
Great pass by Jason Crow. Saw the Auckland Stars coming over on defense and passing it off to Prem Krishna for an easy two.
Casey Frank with it. 13 on the shot clock. AJ now rolls on the outside. Looks to penetrate. Crow goes for the steal. Didn't get it. Shepard out to the country boy for three. Not going to count. We've got a foul called on the Stars.
We got Jonathan Shepard with an offensive charge. Prem Krishna planting his feet. And Jonathan Shepard continue on running into Prem Krishna for the charge.
And well, who saw this coming? The Stars are up over the Pistons here. Jason Crow only sitting on 3 points with just 3 minutes left here in the third quarter. Unheard of.
He won't stay on three for much longer. Piero Cameron has the ball against Casey Frank, sitting on three fouls. He really needs it to be very aggressive and take it to him.
Try and get that fourth foul on Casey, as AJ and will just push PC there.
Yeah, I think they called that one on Adrian Mastrovich, I think, which is going to be his third foul.
And he just came over in the back of PC and pushed him in the back there.
Just trying to help his teammate Casey Frank out. Just try to keep him out of foul trouble, keep him on the court.
PC at the line now. Well short is the first shot. Second shot coming up for Peyro. And that's good as well. 11 points now for Peyro Cameron. And Waikato's up now by 2 points. 60-58. Casey Frank with it. Country boy down low. Yes!
That's George Baker's first point since the first half.
Payroll camera now will bring it up for the Pistons. We're all knotted up here. This one is going to go down the wire very much, I think, like last night's extravaganza before the Saints just put their heel into the throat of the Giants. And there you go, Jason! That's how you do it! That's how you're gonna roll!
You're not gonna shut him down for too much longer. Brian Withers sitting the bench for quite some time now.
Dylan Boucher, nice pass to Casey Frank. He goes baseline, and he'll get his pocket picked. Crow with it! And he sold it! He sold it!
I think he might have bought that one. I think he can sell it.
He definitely did, and he knows he did. He sold that to the referees!
And it went, as we've just been talking about Brian Withers, here he is coming off the bench.
Watch this!
Good hustle from him, getting
That's
his hands
him
onto
hitting
it.
That last. Look at him, he knows. Got away with it. You might have nailed me with a technical, baby, but I got you that time.
I thought I might have saw a little bit of a dance happening.
Jason Crow with it, starting to feel his mojo. Nice pass to Withers, and that's two for Brian Withers. And here comes Tandemonium.
65-60. Auckland Stars need to settle it down a little bit on defense and get a bucket here on the offensive end.
George Baker with it now, top of the key. 12 on the shot clock. Jonathan Shepherd finds it. He penetrates. Out to Mastrovich for three. No go. And they'll get another offensive rebound. AJ will put up another one. That rings out. Boucher's got an offensive rebound again.
Dylan's working really, really hard on that offensive end. Offensive board end, sitting on 7 offensive rebounds.
11 all up so far for Boucher. We got a foul called under the basket. But Dylan Boucher with 11 rebounds so far, doing a lot off the ball, as he always does. My new best mate, Dylan Boucher.
I was waiting for that one, Dan. He is working, he is working.
I think he heard me. He's not too happy about it either. Stars now shooting at a 39% clip from outside. And the Waikato Pistons shooting at a 35% clip from outside. Mastrovich will miss his first from the line.
Once again, as we know, foul shots crucial, especially in playoff basketball.
Second one will go. 4-point spread going the way of the Pistons now, and they've got control. Methodical now. Jason Crow walks the ball up the other end and just totally fakes out the country boy. Wow, what a fake that was. Misses the shot, however. Mastrovich has it.
Brian Withers extending the defense out, really putting the pressure on both ball carriers for the Auckland Stars.
Look at country boy pulling out the street ball moves. Mastrovich spins the other way, walked, got away with it. Who's got it? Boucher was there. The Pistons will maintain possession because that time they saw Dills knocking out of bounds.
So White Kettle, having 14 seconds left on the clock, is going to get something from Jason Crow. They might look at maybe a high pick.
Here we go, last shot of the third quarter. Crow penetrates, finds Ray Cameron, PC, out to Buddy Hill for three, and that will rim out. But fantastic ball movement again from the Pistons, and now they're starting to wake up.
They are going. This is great. Three quarters of basketball. We got one more quarter left to see who's going to be going home.
Well, here are your quarter-by-quarter scoring stats. 21 apiece in the first, 23-19 in the second, and all knotted up in the third. Not a whole heck of a lot in it, Big Easy. The Stars are staying right with them.
And as we thought, this was going to be a great game from the start all the way to the finish.
Let's rock down and listen to Coach Murray McMahon. Murray, what's going on?
Tell a cut flare. Okay, look for that. Especially if Brian's going on that flare, look for that, look for it, and then look inside, okay? Look inside. We need to go more back inside than we were before, okay? Look inside, inside out, okay? When you get it on the end, coming out, that's when you look for your penetration, okay? On that. You got to get out on the shooters.
Hey, if we have a player like that for me or for Jay, we got to get one of us in the weak side post. Because
Waystone,
we
are. Nice, Rick. Nice, Rick. But I'm
hard handoff for sure.
Okay. Chip, where we going? We got
Indian Chip on the same side.
Casey, Chip.
Five, down,
right there. And okay, we're stepping out. There, coming to you. That's right, sorry, yep. Coming to you. Okay. All right, he's coming off you, George.
Yeah.
Okay. Yep. Hand off there. Come and get the pass. Yep. You're going to stay on the screen. Chip, you're going back. Okay?
Put me here and Val there, okay? So I'm going to get the catch and pass back.
No, you're not.
There, the Suzuki cheerleaders here in Tiamutu being as distracting as ever. Dylan Boucher getting into the mix as he always does. 11 rebounds, 2 points for him, but he's been doing so much off the ball. Jason Crow only sitting on 6 points, but two big three-point shots for him. Jonathan Sheppard getting into it as well. One quarter of play left to go in the season for somebody here tonight.
Good three quarters so far. Both teams not giving much away, really battling, trying to keep this in there. And we try to go back inside to Pero Cameron, trying to draw this fourth foul on Casey Frank.
Pero Cameron with it, Benny Hill. Out to Jason Crow. Crow back to PC. PC's looking for the three, launches one. That's gonna be short. And Benny Hill will step on the line. Stars ball. Stars now bringing it up, only down by 4 points. Not much in it. The country boy, who was halfway home last week, finds himself in an enthralling basketball game here in the Super Duper Semi number two. And well, they'll get the ball back, will the Pistons. Bad pass by Jonathan Sheppard into Casey Frank. Trying to thread a needle there, I think, Big Easy.
He was trying to do something. George Baker.
Wow, Benny Hill down low and he's making some room and he'll draw a foul. But geez Louise, Benny Hill ran into George Baker and George Baker just hit the deck like a sack of potatoes.
Just gave him a little bit of a screen there. I don't think George was expecting it, but he sure did feel that one.
Knocked him halfway back to Kentucky. And the crowd here now is starting to get into it as it continues to swell.
Benny Hill with the first points for the fourth quarter. Just extending the lead to five now, and then six.
And he's money from the free throw line, Benny Hill. George Baker now brings it up to the Stars, finds a rolling Dylan Boucher. And we're going to reach in foul, I believe, on Pero Cameron.
Just having a little bit of a hand on the hip, trying to push Dylan Boucher out a little bit more and got pinged for it.
Good minutes by Valance McCarthy there as he's him and Jonathan Sheppard go out. Reese Cassidy and AJ back into the mix. And the country boy has it in the corner. Look at the ball skills from him. Ball on a string like a yo-yo. And he will be, he'll be called with a travel!
Pookie Linden really putting the pressure on him. He saw that George Baker picked up the ball, so really got up on him. Didn't give him much room to do anything but to take a step back and travel.
Jason Crow now methodically, like walking in the park with the ball here, brings it up. Pookie Linden with it, top of the key. Crow has it. Baker's having a tough time staying with him with all these picks. Cameron for three. And that's going to be well short. Casey Frank will track it down. Three on two. Country Boy's got it. He'll go to the rack and he'll take it in. And look at the Stars. They're already all back on defense.
Dylan Boucher now on Brian Weathers. Going to try to put the pressure on him so he can't get nothing easy.
Jason Crow with it, probing. Nice pass, picked off by Boucher. Up to the country boy. He's got Frank on the wing. He'll take it himself and get crushed.
think the foul is going to be on Brian Weathers.
That's Brian Weathers' second foul. Lucky it wasn't on PC there. But the country boy having a rough time of it in the last few minutes. Nice layup from him there. And here he is, just getting chopped in half by both Weathers and PC.
I think he's still feeling the hit from Benny Hill last time.
I think he's still feeling the hit from Peyro in the first quarter. He will not make a mistake, though, and nail the first.
Shook that off for his 14th point.
Casey Frank with 21, Baker with 14. That one will not go in for him. Hill with the rebound. Here comes Jason Crow. Alley-oop to Homaker. Pookie Linden. Homaker will end up with it. Kind of a silly pass there, and there's another one. And the Stars will get possession here.
Crucial coming to this fourth quarter to minimize those mistakes, okay? Lackadaisical passes, just throwing it in there. Really got to be sure of those and fire those passes in.
And the Stars have the opportunity to knot up the game or at least be behind by just one. Boucher with it. Oh, I tried to find Reese Cassidy going baseline. He couldn't handle the pass.
And the turnover count is just increasing each and every time. Auckland on 11 and Waikato on 6.
Wow. Ball conservation must be of the utmost importance here with the last 7 minutes and 30 seconds of this game. Benny Hill with it. AJ on him. Goes for it. No good. Flat shot. Casey Frank falls down. Bodies are everywhere. Baker finds AJ. AJ back to Baker. Chance to tie it up. Yes! Country boy does it!
Once again, another great shot from George Baker to tie the game up at 67 all.
Wow!
He's working hard, as you can see them. A little bit tired, puffing out there.
Look at this. This is like a car accident. Whack, bang, douche. Casey Frank can't believe it. And there is the country boy tying it up here with 7 minutes left in the game. Ray Cameron with it. Who's there? Boucher, Boucher, Boucher.
And this is what Auckland's been doing, extending the defense out, really getting out into the passing lanes and putting the pressure on them to make good passes or go to backdoor.
Prem Krishna to inbound here. 16 left of the shot clock for the Pistons. Benny Hill with it. Prem Krishna now. Country boy looking to pick his pocket clean. Homick spins around. High arcing shot, but there's Brian Weathers to clean it up off the glass.
On that possession there, they got a good shot. Didn't go in, but we saw 3 White Kettle Pistons inside the lane, giving that to that offensive rebound.
Adrian Mastrovich looks to penetrate, spins. Nice dish into Dylan Boucher. Boucher misses. There's AJ with the rebound, and there's AJ with 2 points. Adrian Mastrovich, all heart.
Adrian finally got his double-double on 18 points, 10 rebounds with that great offensive rebound and putback.
Ray Cameron down low. And there will be a foul called on the play. And that'll be on Reese Cassidy.
I don't see Ray doing too much wrong, D. Every time he's out there, he's productive.
Yep.
And he gets the job done for the White Kettle Piston.
Absolutely. And we say Ray Cameron's name twice because he's not quite as cool as Tony Webster. So we say Ray. He's at the line. These are big free throws for him. We're all knotted up at 69 with 6:09 left to go. And the first one will rattle home. And Dennis Katsanos just came up to the commentary position with a piece of paper with 2 letters on it that scared me. O-T with a question mark. Oh,
and
man.
That was a great thing, what Casey Frank just did. The foul shot was hanging up on the rim. He went up there and tapped it out.
Mastrovich loses it. Will they maintain possession? Yes, they will. 50 in the shot clock. Stars have it.
Only 1 point separating these 2 teams. And as we said, not too many players actually do that. They see the ball hanging up on the rim.
Country boy! No good! shot clock, tries to feed it inside. And Stars will maintain possession.
And they're not making anything easy on the defense and both teams.
Baker to inbound. Finds Reese Cassidy. He'll go baseline. He's got a lane. Finds Mastrovich. He'll pop it up and drop it. AJ's come to play tonight. Now with 20 points and 12 rebounds.
He's got a sweet stroke that he does.
Jason Crow with it now, trying to counterattack, trying to answer. Ray Cameron into Hommick. Hommick working on AJ. He'll spin and go baseline. He's got it if he wants it, and there it is. Nice work from him.
Yep, good spin baseline, and he used the rim and the net to basically defend off the defender.
Great extension from AJ. Casey Frank for three. That rims out, but another offensive rebound. Somehow, Withers will end up with it. Withers goes by him all. Oh, Casey Frank, transaction canceled.
Denied.
AJ back the other way, 20-footer. Oh, man. Adrian Mastrovich is playing like a man possessed.
What great basketball we're seeing here. Nobody trying to give anything away. Either one of these teams do not want to go home, and they're showing it out here on the floor, battling it out.
Stars up by one. Payroll Cameron with it.
He needs to take it straight at him, try to draw that foul.
Hommick draws it instead, but good passing. Once again, you're right, Big Easy, by PC down low. He's good like that. And this is truly a battle. Brian Withers going up for it. Casey Frank saying no. Feeling the mojo is Casey. And look at Mastrovich. He's just shooting fantastically.
And he's heating up. And that's not a good sign for the White Kettle Pistons.
Well, he was the MVP of the league a few years ago, and he's definitely showing why here tonight. Auckland now shooting from 38% from outside as Waikato shoots from 30 from outside.
Good minutes for Mike Hammond, giving Buddy Hill a little bit of a rest so he can come out and be the three-point threat that we've always known him to be.
Benny Hill only stuck on 7 points at the moment. Dylan Boucher with it, finds Reese Cassidy. Back out to Casey. Casey looks to dribble, penetrate. Oh, geez, who's got it? Nice pass out to Reese Cassidy again. Bit of miscommunication there. He's going to launch it anyway. That's off the mark. And somehow Dills and PC get tied up. Withers comes back the other way.
Damn, that is a tough shot. Brian Withers, feeling confident as he is. 1-on-3. 3 Auckland Stars back. He pulls up for a 3-point shot.
Mastrovich again. That's going to be a little bit short. He is human. Boucher will get that. After Withers tries to save it, they'll get a fresh 24, 20 in the shot clock for the Stars. You think they need to score here to keep in touch here with the Pistons?
You don't want to get them too far of a gap. Casey Frank shooting from three.
Oh, it rims out! Look at the bodies flying down low!
Once again, we see Dylan Boucher, Perro wrapped up, going to the ground.
Dylan Boucher's going to have splinters everywhere tomorrow. And just when it starts to get heated up, Jason Crow has a smart way of slowing things down. There's a rolling Brian Withers. Casey Frank got off ball.
He's heated.
I think he got off ball better.
Hey, that was a very good defense from Casey Frank. I thought he got hand on all ball, but Tim Brown thought he saw something different.
Let's have a little looky-loo at it. That was all ball, baby. That was all ball.
It is hard when you're playing good defense and you're not getting rewarded by the calls.
Pistons 77, Stars 73. Let's rock down to the trenches and coach Kenny Stone.
We're getting all the open looks and long motion. We're getting open looks like crazy in motion. Even the cuts are open. I'm not saying force it, but even the cuts are wide open.
And we need to say spread then, and then get some cuts at the basket. Right now we're just settling for stuff.
Say it again.
We're just settling for stuff around the outside. We need to get stuff going to the basket. Okay? All right, well, let's stay in motion then. Let's stay in motion. Okay?
Shovel, baby.
Hey, shuffle big. Shuffle big. All right, let's go. Let's execute it. It's time. Hey, we got to do a job down at this end. And get on the board. Don't ball watch if you're the weak side. Don't ball watch. Okay, let's go.
Come on, fellas.
Hey, how bad do you want it?
Let's go, win.
Well, Jason Crow back on the court here. They want the Saints. The Stars want the Saints. Who is going to get them? Weather's at the line. Up in here.
They know how crucial these foul shots are.
Second one is off. And we've got a foul called on Derek Boucher. Holy moly!
It's Dylan's third foul. You know, you hate to see some of these calls being made at times.
Let's have a look at it.
I think he just stepped on Dylan's foot. Accidental contact. Tough one for Dylan. But the call was made.
Pookie Linden at the line here. First one is gold.
And the lead increases to 6.
Quite possibly one of the biggest leads of the game here with 3:07 left to go. PC runs over the country boy on the way out.
He's really putting a punishing on a lot of the Auckland Stars players.
It's kind of like a steamship running over a tugboat. Casey Frank penetrates, finds AJ, it's hot as heck. Yes, AJ keeps continuing to punish the Pistons.
He's just feeling it, and this is what Auckland needs right now. He's feeling it, get him the ball.
They need to stop right here as well with 2:42 left to go, down by 5. Crow with it, finds PC, wants to launch a 3, and that is not going to be. And the Stars will get the ball back.
Good defensive stance, not giving them nothing easy. Putting bodies on there.
Chance to close it up even more here. And look at that, Brian Weathers didn't even see the ball. He just put his hands up and knew it was coming.
And that was a smart play from Brian Weathers. As the cutting George Baker went to the hole, just put his hands up. Benny Hill, great opportunity to take Casey Frank to the hole.
And he will do that. I think he heard you, Big Easy, because it happened.
Well, they got to realize this. Casey Frank is in foul trouble right now. They really need to take it at him. He's not going to try to play his hardest.
Oh, country boy from downtown.
He keeps the lead respectable with 4 with a minute 55 left on the clock.
Big defensive stanza here for the Stars. And the country boy's pumped.
Slapping the ground,
he's
saying he's
going to
make a defensive stance.
Pookie Linden, no go. Boucher rebound. Here come the Stars. Look at that pass. Oh, man. What a pass from the country boy. Unbelievable.
Only 2 points in it.
Oh, man. 1:27 left to go. See, throw it away. Stand up and watch the rest of this one. Oh, you gotta be kidding me! Stars get the ball back.
Minimize your mistakes. Right now, they're just throwing it away.
Ball conservation is just so important right now. We've got a timeout called on the floor. Unbelievable scenes here. 82-80. Stars are down by 2. Will have possession when they resume.
The flare screen, okay? Swing with him setting the flare screen. Throw it to the flare. You go on. Post, throw it into the post. We go from there. Okay, so we get a bit of movement getting it into the post. Everybody got it? Everybody understand? Swing with you setting the flare screen. Okay, you're coming off. Get it to the flare man. Dump it into Pero. Go from there. Okay, everybody know?
Hey, no food. Come on, open one.
I'll get that little
baby. AJ, okay. Hey, you gotta set that screen and sell that. You gotta sell that. So he has to help a little bit.
Don't step out and set it.
Hey, you go under. Try to go under that. No, no, no. Go over and run into it. And think of it.
Well, you want me to go over?
Go over. It is there.
Okay, okay, okay.
Don't come too high. My man's gonna have to go down.
Well, we saw the shot that potentially saved his season with Casey Frank against the Naki, but look at that pass from the country boy to Adrian Mastrovich. Mastrovich now with 26 points, 12 rebounds.
Auckland Stars not wanting their season end, wanting to make the finals, doing everything they can, and they have a chance to either tie it up or take the lead right here.
Here they come. Buckle up and put your tray table up, because we're in for a bumpy ride for the rest of this one. Frank with it, hassled by Benny Hill.
As we can see, Whitekettle Pistons really extending that defense out there, putting the pressure onto him, as we saw PC fly into his own bench.
PC getting a hand in there. 7 seconds left of the shot clock here for the Stars. You think they'd have to try and get a good look with 7 seconds left. Dylan Boucher with it. In the corner! Oh, there he is! Dylan, perfect tape! Jason Crow with it now. This is a big defensive stanza for the Stars. Will Cinderella find her shoe?
47 seconds left on the clock. Jason Crow looking. They're going to try to get a high pick and roll with Peril Cameron. Oh, a double pick here, so he can use either side.
Crow goes to penetrate, stops, puts up a 20. Dagger!
That's a huge shot from Jason Crow. Hasn't scored many points yet so far, but what crucial two to hit them right there.
And big dagger by Jason Crow, who only has 8 points, but big points. And those guys were pumped.
So it'd be good to hear what Kenny Stone has to say in this huddle.
Just 4 points in it. Here he is.
I want to go a quick black. Okay, quick black. I want a foul.
How many before they're in the bonus?
Make or miss.
How many are they in the bonus? No, how many do they have before they get the bonus?
No, they got a foul three. We're in the bonus, okay? Okay. Hey, quick black, and I want to foul anybody but Crow. I'd rather not foul Crow.
24 seconds on the mic.
Yeah. Yeah, I want to get it. So we got
first.
Yeah.
Still. Yeah. Hey, I'm out. Don't let him go long. Yeah.
Hey,
I'm out.
If we get a good if we get a good trap.
Man up, except I'll get back.
Yeah. Don't go all the way back. So if we get a good trap, we got to steal.
Let's go. B, 1, 2, 3, B. Okay. Hey.
All right.
This is on.
It's all this on here.
Come on, folks.
Just 4 points in it. Who is going to meet the Wellington Saints in the big dance next week?
Crucial possession for Auckland Stars. They need to get a good bucket going to the basket or a good open shot.
And they got Dylan Perfect Tate, who's always looming out there in three-point land. George Baker with it. They've got to be on the look at the bodies flying in George Baker's heart. And Casey Frank can't believe it. Baker's down. Cameron landed on his leg. Oh, no. Baker's down.
Peril Cameron fell on top of George Baker's leg.
That looked awkward. That is not good.
If we could see a bit of a replay here. Both of them, Casey Frank, Peril Cameron, both tangled up here.
Right there. Oh, man.
That is not a good sight.
He's getting up. He's putting a little bit of pressure on it. That's got to be sort of a good sign, but that is amazing to have 125 kilos of Peril Cameron coming down on your leg. That's good sportsmanship from PC to go check him out, too.
It wasn't on purpose or anything. It's just the way they fell.
And look at the country boy walking under his own power.
He knows how important this game is. He wants to be out there, and he's going to try to give everything he can right now.
Holy smokes! He's going to stay out there after that looked like he almost broke his leg. The country boy continues to hobble, but he's going to stay out on the court.
I don't think your leg's supposed to bend like that. But, yeah, he's out there. He's just trying to keep it loose, moving it, grimacing a little bit as he's walking. But he's going to need help from his teammates if he gets beat.
Well, here we go. Jason Crow with it. They're going to foul him right off the bat. And these are big free throws for Jason Crow. He's been putting daggers in the back of the Cinderella Auckland Stars all night long. Will he continue to do it now from the charity stripe?
As Dylan comes up, gives him a little pat, trying to put him off.
These are biggins. Oh, he misses the first!
Auckland Stars have done exactly what they wanted to do to come out here. They kept the game close all the way through, and it's still a close game. 18 seconds. If he misses both of these foul shots, anything can happen.
And usually does, as we've seen.
He hasn't missed many all game long.
And you got to think somewhere down in Wellington, Nick Horvath and Kevin Owens are digging their fingernails into a table, realizing they might have to go up against the Goliath that is Pedro Cameron.
It's only 6 points in it.
Boucher with two. No, misses it. BC with the rebound. Crow's got it now.
Great game once again that we saw here tonight. Auckland Stars really giving it their all, as we saw, scrapping to the end. George Baker going down, knee injury, staying out there, trying to make a victory.
An unbelievable game of basketball, ladies and gentlemen. And I'll tell you what, if you think this week was good, you just wait till next week when these Pistons take on the Wellington Saints.
Oh, we're going to have some great matchups next week. With Jason Crow, Brian Weathers against Lindsey Tate, Luke Martin.
Oh, man.
Nick Horvath, Kevin Owens, everyone else that they have against the big guys here from Hamilton.
And Kenny Stone, hold your head up high, my man, because you and your Stars have played valiantly against adverse conditions the last 2 weeks of this season. Good on you, guys. Let's throw things down to Dennis with Coach Murray McMahon. Dennis!
Murray, how are the nerves?
They're all right. We've got a lot of work to do. We guts that one out. We worked hard. We didn't wasn't pretty. It was messy. We didn't do a lot of things as what like we should have, but we got the win with some hard work.
You got the weekend off, and then Tuesday night you're back here. You're going up against the Saints. Congratulations on making the finals. Now, how are you going to combat a team with so much depth?
Five players on the court at one time, one ball. They've got depth, but we've got good players as well, so it'll be a good game.
Anything in particular you want to prepare for against them?
No, they're pretty good all round, so we've got to prepare an all round game and make sure they don't look to have any weaknesses. They've got to contact what we do. We've got some good players, we've got some strong players. Last time we played them, we attacked them inside and did a pretty good job, so we'll go there.
All right, congrats again, Murray. I'll see you Tuesday.
Okay, thanks.
Here's some highlights for you. Unbelievable.